Creepin with Code Orange.
With?
Oh wait, Creepin for Code Orange. I'm your host, Laura.
I'm Joel, and I'm driving, and I've already spent some money.
Yeah, we kind of forgot to film when we were in Home Goods.
We got excited.
We did, because can I tell them why? That you get your...
Just leave the, you know, out.
Yeah.
You can explain the why.
He does like a... What is it called?
It's a biometric screening at work.
And they give you money to buy, like, cooking and baking stuff. So, in true Newlydeads fashion, we decided to buy spooky stuff. So
I told my beautiful wife that I wanted to have an entirely spooked out house. And she said, okay.
Yeah.
And so we've been working on that now for 4 years.
Yeah,
and
replacing everything with, like, something spooky themed.
Not everything has a spooky thing.
No.
We're finding out.
Yeah.
There's no spooky spatulas that we've found yet.
No spooky, like, turners. Like, there's spatulas, but, like, none of the flippy turner thing. So, these people in front of us look like their car's on fire.
Either that or they're vaping really hard. Either way.
Scurry.
It's weird.
We just got some really cool stuff, like salt and pepper shakers and bowls. And
have you ever seen Supermarket Sweep? It was kind of like that, but on a smaller scale, because they don't have that much available. But...
No. But now we're headed to Marshall's, and we went to Marshall's in July also, but I want to stop by there to see, like, if they have any more Code Orange. And then we did stop at Target. It looked like their Target section was pretty, like, they were starting to put out, like, some pumpkins and, like, fall stuff.
It's cheap. It's pretty good quality.
Well, that was, like, I was talking about the dollar spot part or whatever. Right. But, like, but they've got this, like, section where they're starting to put, like, skulls and pillows. And it, like, was good quality, but, yeah, inexpensive. Like when he says
shocked.
Cheap, he doesn't mean, like, cheap crap or whatever. Like, it was nice,
like,
stuff.
$10 for stuff that's pretty good size.
Yeah. I got a blanket. So we'll show you what we bought. I don't have any footage of, like, the actual...
We were a little too excited, and we're just like,
yeah. So
now I'm driving,
and now he's driving. That's my favorite thing that he's ever said. So now I make him say, "I'm driving."
Although last night on the way home, I made her spill her drink because she was laughing so hard.
Yeah, because we were kind of. I'm gonna tell him the story. Yeah, we were eating these Reese's peanut butter
snack cakes. They were not cakes.
No, it was like
bricks.
Yeah, they were. I mean, I liked it, but
they literally weighed like a half a pound.
Yeah,
each.
When he was like, "Boy, this is heavy," and it looked like he was gonna roll down his window, and I was like, "What are you gonna do? Throw your, you know, candy bar out the window?" And he was like, "Yeah, and I do. If I do that, like, the car behind me explodes, and I don't know why, but that just, like, killed me. I thought it was so funny. Can we stop here first? We're gonna go to Five Below first. So we'll see if they have any spooky stuff, and then I also want to see if they have, like, this table that I saw on TikTok. It's like a speaker table, like Bluetooth speaker.
For speakers.
So, for speakers.
Of the house.
Yes.
Only.
So, see you soon. So we're done Halloween decor hunting for Code Orange. We did a bad job. We're both really freaking tired and forgot to record some footage when we were in Marshall's, but I did buy a couple things. So we're gonna go grocery shopping now and then go home and then do an unboxing of the things that we got. Do you have anything to say, Mr. Joel?
I'm driving. Because that's what she wanted me to say. But yeah, we are really tired. But
yeah, we were up late. I had a lab appointment. No one cares.
It's going to look like we spent a lot of money, but
yeah,
only part of it is actually our money.
Yeah. Yeah.
Only a small part of it.
Yes, but I bought some cute mugs. Not that I need any more mugs. I know, I was just showing myself.
I'm like, because I'm an angel. I'm stopped right now, so I'm safe to talk.
You are safe to talk.
But now I'm driving.
Now he's driving. Oh, see?
See? I'm driving. Oh, yeah. Like 5 hours of sleep.
Yeah.
Is not enough sleep right now.
No. We've been out and about since like 7:30 this morning, driving and stuff. Yeah, it's
noon now, and now we have 3 hours worth of groceries. About 2 hours-ish.
And then I gotta go help my brother move stuff out of my house. Because he's moving and I'm selling my house. If anybody wants to buy a house in Rockford, let me know! Alright, I will talk to you later. Hi! So we're back home now and I'm gonna do a quick haul of the stuff that we got. So since I didn't get a lot of the footage from Marshall's, and I don't think I recorded much at a Home Goods or Target either. I think the only place that I really recorded was like Michael's, and we didn't even get anything from there.
Whoopsie.
So I'm just going to show you a few things, and then you'll see Joel because he's going to do the Target haul that we got. It's just a
haul.
Few things.
We got a few things here.
We did get like a good haul from Home Goods though. And that's because of the little bonus thing that Joel has. We love getting our dogs like Halloween themed toys. And we also love these little pigs. And so in particular, like these are like Halloween colored pigs and like they're like miniature sized. I'm probably going to freak my dogs out, but there's two of them. I know, Bailey loves these and they usually honk like a oinky pig or whatever, but yeah, this is a Halloween dog toy. And then, Shaggy doesn't really have any of his own toys yet and we love Frankenstein. And so I found this. Yeah. I can hear him like over there crying cause I made the thing squeak.
But this one is specifically for Laura's job, because...
Yes, I'm taking this to work with me. He doesn't have anything to, like, play with when he's there. He's been playing with this little ball. He's crying now, because I made the squeaks. He's been playing with this little ball, so I got him a Frankenstein. And then the last thing I got at Marshall's was this adorable mug. So, it's, like, vintage print and like super duper cute, and it was only like $4.99 or something like that
because it's Marshall's.
Yes. And then the other thing I got from there was a bag of chips because I like weird chips, and it's spicy Chinese mustard chips, and I'm like, I love spicy Chinese mustard and I love chips.
Wait,
so
we like weird chips.
We do like weird chips. So that's it from Marshall's.
And if you want to hear us talk about weird chips, check out our Sinister Snacks.
Now you got to deal with this guy. So, the first thing we're going to talk about now is Target. When I say the first thing, she was already talking about the first thing. Anyway, you get the point. So, Laura got this schmancy little hide and eek blanket. It was the only one they had. Incidentally, Target, as we said earlier in the video, relatively cheap, like $10 for any of the items, and they're all pretty nice quality. But Laura liked this pattern because she, of course, loves Halloween and black and white stripes, but that is not black and white, that is orange and black. I purchased this fine little fellow. We, of course, have a lot of pillows around the house. This is one that we don't have, and if you can feel it, here, I can feel it. It's very soft and very squishable.
We can't leave these out in the main area too much because the dogs have shedding things. But shedding things. I can see Bailey liking this. This is a PG show. I guess you can say that on PG shows now. This is the next thing I purchased. It is a school bowl. We have a theme in both the restrooms, our restroom and the kids' restroom, that is, we have skulls in our restroom that we use for, like, Laura's glasses, the toothbrushes. There's just a lot of skulls everywhere. And in the other bathroom, we have skulls for the decor. So this one we may use for, you know, bathroom-type supplies. I couldn't read what she was trying to say.
I was like, show the inside. It's a bowl.
Again, $10. Pretty solid. And it is, yes, a bowl for putting stuff in. They put it as a candy dish, but we think outside the bun, so.
The bun?
And this was Laura's next purchase, which is super cool. It is also hollow inside, as you can tell. It is black, and as we are fans here of the Jawless Wonders, this fine little gentleman, I don't know where he's going.
Oh, he's a candle holder, though.
He's technically a candle holder, but...
I'll probably put stuff in him. I know, it's cute.
This one was not $10, this one was $20, but as you can see, I think it's worth it. So we bought a couple of skulls. Then, as we were talking about the chip thing, I bought, Lay's right now is doing another one of their flavor things, but this time they're swapping with other flavors from other chips that they have. So
types of chips.
Yeah, so the one I bought that
like
Laura saw.
Like non-potato chip.
Was kettle cooked chili cheese Fritos, and I love chili cheese Fritos, one of my favorite things. And so this one is a potato chip, but chili cheese Fritos, they also have like...
Show them.
Can we just show them? Okay. Yeah. They've also got some other ones that Laura mentioned. There's a Funyuns one, there's a...
Cool Ranch Dorito, and Cheetos.
Flamin' Hot Cheetos?
No, just regular ass Cheetos.
Regular ass Cheetos, okay. But yeah, we're excited. So we're going to do a show on this at some point, not sure when yet. But this one and her Chinese mustard one we're going to do. And then the thing that we love right now is truffles. If you don't know what a truffle is, it's an egg with cheese and...
You cook it in a thing. That's it. It's literally just one egg, a quarter cup of cheese, and then, yeah, you mix it all together, and it makes two mini little waffles.
And if you put it on, like, toast or an English muffin or something... And use some like light butter, and I put sometimes a little ham on it or something. You can have a pretty big breakfast for not a lot of calories.
We needed an extra waffle maker because we make them so often that it takes forever to make them because I'm making like a double batch sometimes. So like I make one for me and I make one for Joel. So by the time like his are done, it's getting kind of cold. So
it's a lot. And if you are in the Rockford area and you stop by the State Street Target, they have these repackaged, I'm not sure why, but they're marked down from the price. So this one we got for less than $5.
Yeah, and it was like originally like $12.99 or $14.99, something. I think it was like $12.99. I think it says it on there.
Was $7.
Oh.
This one was.
Yeah.
I find that hard to believe because
the other before, ones were yeah, before that, yeah. I think it was like $12.99 or something.
It's been
like
repriced
that.
A couple times maybe. But
yeah.
These are neat, and they've got other ones that do other things that aren't waffles. Like there's one that has a skull on it, one that has a pumpkin, but
turkey.
Those do like pancakes or something.
Yeah, some of them do pancakes. I've got one that makes like little mini bundt cakes.
But they're all tiny.
But I like the waffle maker. So. Yeah.
That is Target. Ooh, I hit the door.
All right. And I will be right back with...
TJ Maxx.
TJ Maxx. No. I had Marshalls. We didn't go to TJ Maxx. What else did I buy?
Why does the bag say TJ Maxx?
Oh, because it's Home Goods. Home Goods is the... yeah, so we're going to split up the Home Goods.
Because Home Goods is a lot.
And some of the stuff I bought, so...
Sure.
Yeah, all right.
And I'm back! So, this is the Home Goods portion. Again, we... Went a little, like, more than what we normally would, just simply because Joel had some little funds that he got from his health. What is it called again?
It's just a perk of my, you do a biometric screening.
Yes, and then they give you some money to, like, buy, like,
but it's stuff. Earmarked specifically for primarily things related to health and wellness, but
cooking,
it includes bakeware, cookware, things involved
yes.
with the kitchen.
And so, like we were saying before, we're trying to, like, replace spooky stuff with all of the, like, normal things that we have. So some of it is from that, and then some of it is, you know, stuff that I bought or whatever.
The majority of it is part of that. So you'll be able to tell when we show you that. Yeah.
But the first thing is something I bought, and this is one of those door draft window draft, like, guards that you put underneath the door. And the reason that I bought it was because Bailey, our 8-year-old Shih Tzu, had a little accident in our bedroom, which he normally does not do, but he woke up in the middle of the night and kind of ruined our other one. And so I was like, I know I saw that they had, like, ball-themed ones, and then when we went there, it wasn't. It was just, like, a green one, and I was sad. And then we came back today, and I was like, I knew it! So this one is cute, it's black and whatever, and it's got white pumpkins on it, so. So
it falls into the black and white stripes sort of category.
Kind of, yeah, but also fallish, kind of Halloween-ish. It's a little more farmhouse or whatever, but whatever.
If we ever see one that's, like, super spooky, then we'll upgrade maybe, or because we have more than one. We have had more than one before, I think, haven't we? I don't know. Anyway, moving on.
Yes. So, I was so excited about this. So this is Joanna Parker, and I never see Joanna Parker, like, out in the wild, ever. So, I've always wanted the Bride and Frank like this, but they are legit, like, $25 or $30, like, a piece. So, they're, like, crazy expensive. I was going to order them through the Traditions website, which, if you know what that is, it's like a year-round holiday-themed store, and they've got a lot of, like, Halloween stuff. And, like, yeah, so I was going to order them, but it was, like, 25-something per mug, and so it's going to be, like, $50 or $60 shipped for just 2 coffee mugs. So when I saw this, it's not the Bride and Frank, obviously, but it's, like, a cutesy little devil guy, and then, like, a little, like, ghosty pumpkin-y-looking dude. And, of course, we're going to have barking, because that's how it goes. And it was only $20 for 2. So, thumbs up for that. And then the other thing that I found, which I'm pretty sure these are the only 2, like, mug kind of things
that they had
from Joanna Parker. She just does, like, vintage designs, so I just love them. They're always, like, super cute. But this is, like, a creamer set, and it's also $20. Yeah, it's a little pumpkin, and then it's a owl, and it's so cute. It's, like, a little pitcher. So, like, you put your sugar in one and then creamer in the other, and then you have, like, your little tea thing. So now we've got, like, a whole, like, set for Joanna Parker stuff. So, very excited about that. And then if you know me in real life, I collect, salt and pepper shakers, and I usually like Halloween themed salt and pepper shakers, but,
that's one of the first things I bought you.
Yes. He bought me a Bride and Frank salt and pepper shaker that kiss, and they're so cute. So I like spooky themed ones, but I mean, I also collect just, like, weird ones. I've got, like, little tiki guys, or I've got, guinea pigs. Those were super cute. I'm just, like, kind of looking around. I've got, like, a whole setup, of those kind of things, but I found a whole bunch of cute ones. So this is, like, Joel's been into mummies this year, and so I saw, like, the little mummies. And these are all super cheap, $3.99 a piece. So, like, they're super affordable. So, I got mummies. I did get ones that look like Joanna Parker. No, they're not. It looks like Trans Pack Every Day is a Holiday. Yeah, but they totally
look like Joanna Parker.
Design. Yeah, so super cute with that. I'm telling you, when I say I like salt and pepper shakers, I like them a lot. So I got little ghosties.
I mean, I eat a lot of salt, but not this much.
No. I collect them because they're just, like, little art. I like tiny smalls because you can collect them, and then they don't take up, like, a ton of room. I mean, the more you get of salt and pepper shakers, eventually it will. But I got a different kind of little ghosties, and I love them because they're carrying little pumpkins. And I got... Oh, I already did those.
There you go.
Just little pumpkin ones. So I thought these were cute because I like the black and orange. Because you don't really see a whole lot of, like, you know, the black pumpkins a whole lot. Okay, so I also ended up buying, because we don't have any dish rags. These are dish rags. Dishcloths. And they were super cute. So I got these.
Any that are spooky themed, she's
any that are spooky themed. It comes with four. Two of them are spooky. The other ones are black and white, which is also my aesthetic. And then,
you're gonna have to work to get to that.
I'm gonna let you do the
thing.
The other lamp. Yeah, I'm so happy. I got this lamp. I've been seeing it all over the place. People have been like posting about it a lot. So super happy that I got this. It's got spiders and spider webs all over it. When you plug it in, it kind of makes like really cool patterns on the wall. And it, you know, kind of casts like an orange kind of glow. So.
She was very excited.
I was like, oh, lamps. I need to go to the lamp section. And they had a ton of them. They have ones with bats, I think, on them. And then they've also got ones with skulls. And they've got, like, different sizes. So this is, like, the smaller version. There's a bigger version of this one, too. And it was, like, $25. This one was, like, $20, I think. I don't have the thingy on it. But I love it. I'm so happy. Oh, yeah, here it is. $20. All right. So I'm going to have Joel do the rest.
And we're back. All right, so for the rest of the Home Goods, which has been our kryptonite crack, whatever you want to call it this year, we like going there anyway, but every time we go there, they have more, and it's just like they're like...
different.
Caught a vibe, man. All right. Oh, and this is almost sealed, so you can see that. Anyway, so the first thing I got this for my kid. This is not what it looks like. I'm just doing it. I'm trying to be dramatic. We saw these. I had one that was a bride, one that was groom. And when you see, you'll understand. So when you know, you know. But it is super cute. It is kind of classy with this kind of, you know, silver thing going on. But I fell in love with it. And I have a feeling he's going to love it too because it's spooky, creepy. And yeah.
Yeah. He likes skeletons.
Yes.
He knows how to draw skeletons. Like, yeah, that's.
And. Being trans, he is, he's gonna love it.
Yeah.
I'm very happy about that. Mm-hmm. Anyway, okay, moving on. So then we have this little bad boy. This matches another item that we got, which if you can see here, I'm gonna try and move in the cute little characters here and their little night out going trick or treating. Oh, is it shining?
I'm trying to block the light. Now there? You can see me.
Yeah. There's that, and then that.
Jimmy, hold this.
Oh no, I was just gonna say what goes with it, or what we found to go with it.
We actually found that first, and then.
Yep, this big bowl, that you know.
It's huge.
It's just a monster, like you know.
I mean, yeah, they can see. And it was pretty cheap.
Yeah, this was $10, and this was $6, and these both qualify, so these are part of the things we can get. At no cost to us, which is beautiful. Laura has been eyeballing these for, I think since the first time we went to Home Goods this year and they had their Halloween stuff out. This little guy glows in the dark, and these guys don't. So when you have it up in your kitchen, if you go in there at night, you got this little guy glowing at you.
It's not just him. It's him. There's a whole bunch.
Multiple ones. Yeah. Okay. Well, you have two towels.
Yep.
And, again, we're trying to spook up the place. So we got reverse-sided terry towels there. Then in the continual bakeware, we've got this very nice Nordic ware spooky skeleton. You've got the little mold here that then spits out these little cute guys. And as you can see, it's really nice. I mean, Nordic ware is 1946. It's quality. It's good stuff. And we're excited to make some fun things with that. Then we've got these spooked... So, what are these for exactly?
They're like little dip bowls.
Little dip for little dips.
little dip for little dips.
She's bought a couple of tiny bowls. When we're sitting down to watch something, we typically will have an evening snack.
Like I measure it out
or something. It's measured out. Yep. This is how we keep our girlish figures. And so Laura likes to put them in spooky bowls, and these things are perfect size for like a little bit of chips, a little bit of dip, whatever. And they're cute, especially the black and white stripes.
Mm-hmm.
That is her aesthetic to a T. Then we have these fancy little jars that have these little latches that, obviously you know what this is going to do.
It's a canister.
But it's a little canister,
super cute.
For
canisting things.
Canisting?
Yeah, you know, like when you go and there's an election and you go canisting the neighborhood.
You can put, like, you know, sugar in it or something.
Sugar, salt, the ashes of your enemies, whatever you want to put in here that will fit.
Could put dextrose. So you've got...
True. I would feel a little weird about that for the sake of, you know, we'd have to keep the bag closed. We'll talk
it
about
is
it.
It is closed.
Well,
I'm saying put his bag in there.
We can talk about it. It might be something to consider.
All right.
But she got a ghost. They had a cat. They had another ghost that we didn't care for as much. And they had...
a pumpkin with a cat coming out of it.
They had a mummy that was like her salt and pepper shakers. But when you have a mummy with an elongated head...
It looked weird.
So we took a pass on it. I'm running out of room, so I'm going to this side. And the final thing, which is a little weird at Home Goods, because most of their stuff is...
not movie related.
Yeah, they don't.
Not pop culture kind of stuff.
Except for Disney related.
Yes.
Disney they've got, but anything else pop culture they don't. So when we saw this, I mean, we couldn't pass it up.
It's a light.
We love Friday the 13th, and it is a, you know, handy dandy little night. I don't know why it's the 2009 Jason, but it is. That's okay. I like the 2009 remake as well. But it looks like the nice mask when it's off, and then when it's on, it glows, and as you can see, the price there, $14.99.
I bought it. This yeah.
Herself, for us to have in the house, because we always can use an extra nightlight. So I'm not sure where it's going to go yet. I think she had an idea already, but I don't know.
Yeah, like in the bathroom or something, because Shaggy lives in the bathroom at night.
and he loves Friday the 13th.
Yes, yes. It, so. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That is it for the haul. Do we want to, like, do together? No? We did one for July. This is our August. I don't know how much we're going to be spending in September or October, because by this point, we're pretty much getting close to being maxed out on things, probably to some extent.
Yeah, maybe.
But we'll at least have two more hauls to show you, whether it's just video or it's actual things that we have purchased. If we decide to buy more, we kind of save up. This is our Christmas. So... we gotta go. We got dogs happening. So we will see you next time.
Bye.